Thank you, thank you, thank you very much. And welcome to Cats and Dogs here on Press TV with me, Lemma Topic, where we start with more hijinks of the high atmosphere above America. Since the Americans shot down the Chinese balloon on February the 4th, 2023, they've targeted three more high-altitude objects. Now, the Biden administration is under pressure to identify what these objects actually were. That's right, folks, in another shoot first, ask questions later situation, this could turn out to be embarrassing. Because while Washington's had ants in its pants about Reds overhead, meanwhile, one balloon declared missing in action by a hobbyist club has emerged as a prime candidate for one of the three UFOs shot down by US fighter jet launched Sidewinder missiles. Let's look at the economics of it. The amateur balloon is estimated to be worth around $12 to $180, something like that. But the missile costs around $400,000. Seriously, if it carries on like this, the Biden administration will have to ask for a subsidy for American missile defense from Ukraine. Now, while the military keeps claiming the objects were a Chinese spy plot of some sort, rumor has it that American meteorologists are having problems reporting the weather because they've stopped getting data from their weather balloons, which have mysteriously disappeared from the sky. Coincidence? I don't think so. US Homeland Defense radars need to be recalibrated before we see headlines like this. Oops, Sidewinder missiles take a shot at the moon. Remnants of alien spacecraft found near Montana. Santa Claus and his reindeer blasted in midair misunderstanding. Watch out, Air Force One. The military is coming to get you. Millions of Sidewinders wasted in beehive mix-up. While the Western world fixated over balloons, Joe Biden made a surprise visit to Ukraine, apparently to personally deliver Zelensky a bag of cash, promising $500 million more help. Zelensky's lucky to have such a generous sugar daddy. Okay, with other people's money, but hey, they'd only be spending it on Sidewinder missiles and replacement weather balloons anyway. But Zelensky could still be in for a disappointment. If you're looking for true romance, instead of meeting up with somebody who can hug like this, he should stick to people who can hug, hold your hands, and look into your eyes like this. Now, so far, the US Congress has appropriated over $112 billion for Ukraine. This could lead to the worst hyperinflation in modern history if the cash keeps flowing. But maybe that's the plan. Make Ukraine so poor that America can buy it and then sell it to the highest bidder. Maybe Elon Musk or China or Russia. While American jet fighters were shooting down Chinese balloons, weather balloons and potty balloons, a train derailment caused a different kind of mess. A chemical spillage in East Palestine. That's in Ohio. The spill has already drawn online comparisons to the 1986 Chernobyl disaster. No one has taken responsibility for the accident, but surely the finger of suspicion points in one direction. Israel! Yes, this could be part of the regime's mission to wipe out the name Palestine wherever it appears. But what's the truth here? Let's cut through the rumours and talk directly to the man who should know. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to Cats and Dogs, US President Joe Biden. Mr. President, thanks for joining us here on Cats and Dogs.
No problem. You're a whole lot cheaper to talk to than that Romanian guy Zelensky.
Ukrainian?
Yeah, I mean that Romanian guy, Mr. Ukrainian.
All right, never mind. Firstly, are you aware of the problems in East Palestine?
In the West Bank, I guess.
No, the one in Ohio, America?
How did they get to Ohio? Those sneaky Palestinians must have come up from Mexico, I guess.
No, I'm talking about the toxic cloud in Ohio.
Well, if all those Palestinians got to Ohio, I'd say that is pretty toxic.
No, I mean, the chemical spill, the toxic waste accident, what caused that?
Sometimes things just happen. It's like asking what caused me to be the U.S. president, right? Sometimes there just doesn't seem to be a reason for why things happen.
How is your government going to help the residents of East Palestine?
Are we supposed to help them too? As American president, my duty is to help those poor Romanians and their president, Dr. Seuss.
You mean Mr. Zelensky and the Ukrainians?
I don't know. Are there any Ukrainians in Romania?
Let's just leave it there.
Where? Romania? No, wait a minute. I mean Bulgaria. Or was it Costa Rica? Oh, my. With so many countries, it's hard to keep up.
Mr. President, thanks very much and sleep well. Now, back in East Palestine, that's the one in Ohio, not in Bulgaria, Romania, or Costa Rica, a controlled burn of the toxic materials filled the air and spread chemicals in the water and soil. However, despite dead fish in the creeks and a stink in the air, the rather high temperatures from the burning may have tempted many in fuel-starved and freezing Europe to spend the rest of the winter over there. Now, how has the local population been affected? Or has it? Here's some footage of a tourist with a dog and one angry resident. Meanwhile, a new study by Gallup and the Knight Foundation says 26% of Americans have a favorable opinion of the news media. That's pretty shocking. It means one in four Americans still believe the media. That's the media which told them there were weapons of mass destruction in Iraq, the war on terror was good, the American dream is still alive, and that China is evil. Oh, and that Home Alone was a documentary. That really happened. In other news, a devastating earthquake hit Turkey and Syria, and thousands of people lost their lives as the world rushed to the survivors through earthquake relief. With a slight delay, Israel played its part and also finally delivered, but in an unusual way. They decided to bomb Damascus. At least five people were killed and 15 wounded in Israeli airstrikes on Syria's capital, which did big damage to residential buildings. A shaky way to help a quake-struck country. And finally, the Munich Security Conference didn't invite an official Iranian delegation this year. Instead, the Germans sent invitations to Reza Pahlavi, Mazi Alinejad, and Nazanin Bonyadi. Who are they, you might ask? Well, the first one, that's Reza Pahlavi, is the son of the last Shah of Iran, who was overthrown over four decades ago. During his interviews, the son went to great lengths to distance himself from his own father's past record as king of Iran.
So I'm his son, but that doesn't make me a close relative, does it? Well, okay, so I'm the crown prince, but the other way to look at it is, the past is the past.
The second person invited to the conference was an Iranian-American journalist, reportedly on the CIA payroll. And the third one? Well, she's an Iranian-British actress, known for her lesser role in the fantasy series The Lord of the Rings of Power. And now she's playing a new leading role in a new fantasy drama, namely pretending to represent Iran. Over past months, they've been looking for the rings of power. But here's one piece of advice before they actually go to Iran. Check your Google map is working, because it's very hard to find the rings when you don't even know the territory. That's all for this week. Join me again next time to see who's shooting at the moon, who's moaning at Iran, and who's telling Biden where East Palestine actually is. That's all on Press TV with me, Lemotopic, and cats and dogs.